Greetings from Grace Lutheran Church Online Worship Service, Hastings, Michigan. We're glad you could come and join us on this All Saints Day. Entering the church triumphant this week is our brother Jerry Knickerbocker and our sister Elnora Becky Beckwith. We are so thankful that they have been able to walk faithfully for 90 plus years for each of them among us and with us on our journey in faith. On this All Saints Day, may we rejoice that they are alive in Christ Jesus and know the love that each of us can share in gathering together. Wanted to invite you at the end of this month, we begin our Advent time. And on Wednesdays during Advent, the first three Wednesdays, we will have hold an evening prayer with a flare. It'll be a little time of story time and then a little in-depth reflection question time. So we hope that you can join us for those times and sharing. With the two deaths, our pasty sale is going to be moved. We're going to have it on December 3rd for pickup. So just wanted to make sure you knew all of those things that we're needing to change things around, because each of the families have decided to have the funeral on November 19th, which was the day of the pasty sale. So of course we are changing that so that members of the church can attend worship services and to celebrate and to know the love of God in celebration of their lives. God's creation calendars are still available. We hope that you're able to enjoy those calendars. $5 each. It's a beautiful piece of work. The artwork and words are awesome. And finally, wanted to just remind you that we are getting ready for our time of Christ the King Sunday. We celebrate today in white, and we remember the seven that have entered the church triumphant this past year, from All Saints to All Saints. But we also remember those who are worshiping the King of Kings, who have entered the church triumphant a long time ago, or maybe just a couple days ago, as our brother and sister did. May we know that we are able to know God's love each and every day and know God's grace. Now let us enjoy our worship. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
It is good for us to know that we are included in being saints. We often think of those who have gone before us as the saints, and they are, but we also remember that even in our regular, everyday, normal life, we too are saints of God. We did have two enter the church triumphant. Jerry Knickerbocker, he died and entered on Wednesday night, and then our sister Elnora Beckwith on Thursday. So details are mostly done, but the meals haven't been decided or come around yet, even if we're having meals. I know for one we are, for the other we're still.
We are.
Yeah. I'm saying for one we are, that's why I did contact you, because I don't know the rest of the story and how we're going to make it work if there's another meal on the same day. So we will figure this out, and it's in the planning stage. So wanted to let you know about that though. The funerals are on November 19th. Elnora's going to be cremated by that time, but there's a visitation at Gerbach at 7 p.m. this Wednesday if you would like to go and share your condolences there. That information is posted out on the door. There are no further pre-service announcements to share. I invite us to enjoy our gathering music at this time. Thank you. share in reading together. Grace be with you from the Holy Trinity, our true God, who comes to us with the love of a parent, redeemer, and upholder.
Thank you. Grant us grace to follow your blessed saints in lives of faith and commitment, and to know the inexpressible joys you have prepared for those who love you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
Good morning.
Good morning.
The first reading is a reading from Daniel. In the first year of King Belshazzar of Babylon, Daniel had a dream and visions of his head as he lay in bed. Then he wrote down the dream. I, Daniel, saw in my vision by night the four winds of heaven stirring up the great sea, and four great beasts came up out of the sea, different from one another. As for me, Daniel, my spirit was troubled within me, and the visions of my head terrified me. I approached one of the attendants to ask him the truth concerning all this. So he said that he would disclose to me the interpretation of this matter. As for these four great beasts, four kings shall arise out of the earth, but the holy ones of the Most High shall receive the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, forever and ever. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We read responsibly Psalm 149. Hallelujah! Sing to the Lord a new song. God's praise is in the assembly of the faithful.
Let Israel rejoice in their maker. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their ruler.
Let them praise their maker's name with dancing. Let them sing praise with tambourine and harp.
For the Lord takes pleasure in the people, and adorns the poor with victory.
Let the faithful rejoice in triumph. Let them sing for joy on their beds.
Let the praises of God be in their throat, and a two-edged sword in their hand.
To wreak vengeance on the nations and punishment on the peoples.
To bind their kings in chains, and their nobles with links of iron.
To inflict on them the judgment decreed. This is glory for all of God's faithful ones. Hallelujah.
The second reading is a reading from Ephesians. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance toward redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love toward all the saints, and for this reason I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the work of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Then Jesus looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice in that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven. For that is what their ancestors did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is what their ancestors did to the false prophets. But I say to you that, listen, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you. And if anyone does take away your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
What a fantastic thing we have. Believe it or not, this was just growing outside. I picked it off last night because the first one I picked off, which means there were three this week still, were alive and well. But the other one that I brought in on Friday kind of disintegrated. And I thought, okay, that's fine. And the winds were howling and making these move big time, and I thought, uh-oh, by the time I get them in, they're going to be gone. And there are markings and definite hurt, but it's kind of neat to see the resurrection promise on this All Saints Day, this promise of new life, this promise that we have new life. You can see our sanctuary lamp, and we're dedicating that today. And we're going to remember all the saints who contributed to it, but also all the saints it was in memory of. So I invite us to pray at this time. Let us pray. Gracious God, we ask your blessing upon all the saints that are a part of our lives. We are naming 88 of them this morning, but we know there are many, many more. Let us know and celebrate their love among us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Call to the Church Triumphant in 2021 and 22. Beulah Benedict. David Bolton. Mary Dawson. Eileen Hilson. Lois von Segrin. Gerald Knickerbocker. Elnora Beckwith. Addie and William Friedland, parents. Al and Claudia True, faithful new friends. Alice Hayward, mother. Elia Champaco, made a saint by grace. Ainsley Kuhlman, made a saint by grace. Becky Sheck, beloved aunt who helped build internet. Beulah Benedict, wonderful mother. Bill Heil, curmudgeon and raconteur. Bill Poultice, father of Kate Watson. Bonnie Lake, gone but not forgotten. Bud Umberger, wonderful, loving father. Charles and Nancy C., parents. Clara Smith, beloved grandmom. Craig and Lorraine Sheffield, parents. Dawn Goodrich, gone but not forgotten. Denver Kiersey, generous uncle. Eddie Arab, miss you, brother. Edward and Eileen Golnick, beloved parents. Emma and Luke Bolhalski, joined in love. Ernest and Nellie Argo, beloved Poppy and Granny. Ernie and Evelyn Loncourt, mom and dad. Eugene Gino Argo, miss you, dad. Eunice and Gordon Hansen, faithful parents. Fred Kogi, beloved husband. George Ulrich Sr., gone but not forgotten. Gordon Sheffield, brother. Greg Franks, laughs and brings joy. Helen Brown, gone but not forgotten. Henry Carl, brother. Ingrid and Charlie Wilson, loving parents, beautiful couple. Irene Golnick, parents of Gary, Jeanette, and Mary. Jack and Judy H., beloved uncle and aunt. James Curtis Sr., beloved husband and father. James Joseph, brother. Jamie Henyon, son. Jan Schreiner, loving sister and sidekick. Janelle Anderson, gone but not forgotten. Jeff Hansen, supportive brother. Jim Heal, big brother. Joan Millett, great big sister. Joyce Doherty, mentor, friend. Joyce Davini, our beloved sister. Kathy Lord, always ready to sing. Kelsey and Ethan Shett, joined in love. Larry Hansen, generous. Laura Krawitsky, beloved sister. Lauren Kogi, beloved granddaughter. Leah and Carson Mutchler, joined in love. Lester and Josephine Halstead, always set a good example. Lori Gladius, faithful to the end. Lydia Champaco, made a saint by grace. Marion Jacobs, gone but not forgotten. Mary Oler, prayer warrior. Nolan Heath, beloved son, brother, and friend. Patty Kahn, voice of faith. Paul and Mary Kuhlman, workers in the kingdom of God. Pauline Abbasi, helps us think differently. Richard Ogden, gone but not forgotten. Bob Young, faithful father and builder. Robert and Marie Herr, wonderful parents. Sandy and Viola Wilson, parents of Sandy Mosteller. Tim Kemper, dedicated servant. Tom Howard, miss your smile. Tom Watson, loving husband. Travis Moore, his courage works all night in dark to protect us.
Let us pray. Dear God, help us always to lift these saints to you and to live as ones who are your saints, made by your grace. Be with us this day and help us always remember our identity as your children of God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Grace, mercy, peace be to you from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For God has sent us as saints into the world to know that we can share the Spirit's love with all. Amen.
Jesus was a master at keeping his listeners off balance. He was always saying the unexpected. He praised people others despised. He lifted up those others who were put down. Jesus said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for me will save it." And 2,000 years after his death and resurrection, we still wrestle with what exactly Jesus was trying to say. No better example can be found than the Beatitudes of today's gospel reading. Many modern translators contend that the word happy is closer to Jesus' original meaning than blessed. Changing the word for me from blessed to happy doesn't really help. If we did, that translation would read, Jesus said, "You are happy if you are poor, happy if you are hungry, happy if you are downtrodden, happy if you are hated, and happy if you are persecuted." To which most of us would say, "Thanks, but no thanks." We don't want to be poor. We don't want to weep or mourn or be persecuted. It's bad enough that sometimes we feel the world is just plain against us. What is it that Jesus is saying to us about happiness and blessedness? For you and I are not, for the most part, poor. We're usually not hungry. We're not usually downhearted, at least all the time. There are our days, though. We're not hated and we're not persecuted for the most part in our lives. And yet many of us are not happy either. In fact, it seems that people in our affluent, safe, for the most part, comfortable society are more depressed than ever. Where have we missed it, Lord? Where is happiness to be found? Let's dispel the notion that Jesus was a dewy-eyed dreamer, out of touch with the real world. Jesus knew of the hardships. Jesus knew of the pain. Jesus knew of the lives that were shattered by evil in the world. Jesus knew the abuse the people were receiving by those in charge of the kingdom. Jesus had a very different kingdom in mind, a kingdom of the Spirit. Jesus knew the followers would be persecuted. He knew that many of them would be rejected by family and friends. He knew that many of them would live their lives on the edge of abject poverty because of their commitment to him. It's still true today in many parts of the world. Today, as we celebrate All Saints' Day, even though it's almost a week late, we celebrate those who are about saintly living. Saintly living is not about cloistering ourselves away from the world, though many saints have found much joy in developing that kind of intense relationship with God. For most of us, though, saintly living is about turning the world of human values upside down on its head. Saintly living is about moving from values which are survival-based to values that are faith-based. It is about moving from a life that is self-centered to a life that is God-centered and other-centered. Saintly living is about moving from a life in which we are conscious of what we lack to a profound gratitude for all we have. Thus we find true happiness. Thus we find true blessedness. Thus we celebrate the love that has come to those who have entered the church triumphant and yet somehow is still part of our lives here on earth. Each of us knows the power of God's rich blessing poured upon us as we know the love, friendship, and grace that has touched our lives through one another and through God's grace. Jesus was no dewy-eyed dreamer. Jesus was just the opposite. He knew that lasting happiness is not found in wealth or a full stomach or the esteem of friends or even family relationships. Though all of these can satisfy for a while, all of these are definitely important, but there is only one source for true and complete happiness, and that, my friends, is our good and gracious God. I pray that each of us find strength in God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, as we give our brother, sister, mother, father, aunt, uncle, cousin, or friend to our Savior's care. Let each of us find courage to move ahead and share in God's grace and care. Let each of us, as we remember our loved one, come and know that we can celebrate the fact that our loved one is alive forever with our good and gracious God, who never leaves us or abandons us. Let us know this love for a lifetime that comes to us from our Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, our true God. Amen.
Thank you.
rests on the faithful who came before us. Give bishops, pastors, deacons, and lay leaders the will to carry the church forward and discern your will for the future, especially Bishops Elizabeth and Craig, Assistants David and Roseanne, our Synod Companion, Resurrection Lutheran Church, Saginaw, Quimby United Methodist Church, Hastings, Minister of Music Cindy, and Pastor Ken. We come before you, O Lord.
I invite us to arise in body or spirit to share the peace together. The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Let us share that peace with one another.
Except the gifts
you have first given us, which we bring to your table. Nourish us now in the light that is really light. Reveal to us Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Holy God, you alone are holy. You alone are God. The universe declares your praise beyond the stars, beneath the sea, within each cell, with every breath.
We praise you, O God.
Generations bless your faithfulness through the water, by night and day, across the wilderness, out of exile, into the future.
We bless you, O God.
We give you thanks for your dear Son, at the heart of human life, near to those who suffer, beside the sinner, among the poor, with us now.
We thank you, O God.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink of this cup, we proclaim that Jesus is among us. Remembering God's love for us on the way, at the table, and to the end, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We pray for the gift of your Spirit in our gathering, within this meal, among your people, throughout the world.
Blessing, praise, and thanks to you, Holy God, through Christ Jesus, by your Spirit, in your church without end. Amen.
Gathered by the Holy Spirit, let us pray how Jesus first taught.
Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
invites you to this table. Come, taste and see.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. As you can tell, I don't know why, but Deborah decided to fill them up. So you will receive the bread from me, and when you pick up the wine, you will hear the words from Randy. The body of Christ given for you. 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 The tentative date that I have heard is now December 3rd. So just keep that in mind, and we have several weeks to try to get the manpower, people power, woman power back in place, and you will be notified and asked if you can still work that type of thing.
if you've already signed up. Or we may just play the game where, hey, it's not too late to sign up. Sign up and put new signage up. With the names already who have signed up and if it can't work, do the cross out thing. That might be what we do. It just might be easiest. I don't know. That again is being in flux. You know, I haven't even heard that this is for sure if we're doing it that day. I've just heard I'm checking with people. So nothing's concrete. Just wanted to make sure you knew it wasn't concrete. Same as our meals. We just don't know what our meals are happening for that day on the 19th. We do know this, that our plan is to have Advent services on Wednesday night. The change is 6:30 meal. 6:30. Then a 7:15 service. We have manpower again, or people power, missing, so we have to change our time for worship for sure, and it would just mean another 45 minutes of waiting around if we were, because our worship time can't start until the 15th hour. Wanted to also let you know that we are still having God's Creation 2023 calendars available. And as you can feel, the heat is on. If you are uncomfortable or need to turn up your heat, please do so. But return it by hitting the run button at any time. And I know that we're preparing for singing for the Psalms. I don't know if you've heard anything, but we are still in the planning phase of that. And we'd like to get a big, long list of rotation instead of four people doing it once a month. It would be great to see nine people do it and have to do it once every 2 months and then some. So that'd be really cool. Are there other verbal mission minutes that should be shared? Okay, well, I invite us to stand for the blessing found on page 9. God, who gives life to all things and frees us from despair, bless you with truth and peace. And may the Holy Trinity, one God, guide you always in faith, hope, and love. Amen. Thanks be to God. Thank you.
Thank you.